Right then, for today's video, we're going to be taking a look at finding the area of compound shapes. We actually looked at compound shapes in our last video where we were looking for the perimeter. If you want to check that video out, I'll leave a link for it in the description, and I'll also put a card in the top corner. So for this first question, we need to find the area of the following compound shape. So what we can actually do with questions like these is split them into separate shapes. So if I cut the shape down that dotted line, I'd have a rectangle, and I'd also have a triangle. Then looking at my original diagram, I know the width of this is 6 centimeters, and I know the height is 5 centimeters. Now looking at this triangle, because I know this rectangle here, the height was 5, that length there was 5, which means this length here is also going to be 5, which is a shared side with the triangle, so I know the height of the triangle is 5 centimeters. And now we need to look for the width of the triangle. Well, going back to the rectangle, if I know the length of this is 6, then the length of this would also be 6. So the entire length of that bottom side is 10 centimeters. So if we know the length of the rectangle is 6, then that must mean the remaining bit, which is the base of the triangle, must be 4 centimeters. So now all we're going to do is find the areas of both shapes. So for the rectangle, I'm simply going to do base times height. And for my triangle, I'm going to do base times height, but then I need to divide that by 2. So we've got the base of the rectangle is 6, multiplied by the height of 5, that's going to give us 30. Then for this triangle, we've got to do the base, which is 4, multiplied by the height, which is 5, we then have to divide that by 2. So we've got 4 times 5, which is 20, we then divide that by 2, that would give us 10. So we've got the area of the rectangle is 30, the area of the triangle is 10, so all I have to do is add those two together. So we've got 30 plus 10, which gives us 40. So then for our final answer, we need to use the correct units. So the answer to this would actually be 40 centimeters squared. And that would be the answer to that question. So this can be extremely useful for when we've got compound shapes, where we can split them into two separate shapes and use separate diagrams to make things a bit clearer. Okay, for this next question, we've got to find the area of this compound shape. So again, just like before, I'm going to look for shapes that I can split this into to make it just a bit clearer. So what I'm going to do for this one, I'm going to take a line down here, and I'm going to cut this compound shape so that I now have a triangle and a rectangle. So if I just draw them separately to the side, I'm going to have the triangle like this, and then I'm going to have this long rectangle that comes down like this. So let's look for the dimensions. So I'm going to do the rectangle first. I know the base is 3 centimeters and the height is 12 centimeters. Now for this triangle. Well, if I look at the rectangle, I know if this length here is 12 centimeters, then this whole entire length here must also be 12 centimeters. So that must mean that the little missing bit there, which is the height of the triangle, must be 4 centimeters, because we've got 8 centimeters. We then have to add another 4. So the height of this triangle would be 4 centimeters. We're going to do a similar thing for the width of the triangle. Going back to the rectangle, I know that this dimension here is 3, which means this at the top is also going to be 3. Well, if the entire length of that top side is actually 7, that means the missing bit is just going to be 4 centimeters. So now for our areas again, for the triangle, we're just simply going to do base times height and then divide that by 2. Well, we know the base is 4. We're going to multiply that by the height, which is 4. Then we divide by 2. So we've got 4 times 4, which is 16. Which then when we divide it by 2 gives us 8. So that's the first bit we're interested in. And then for the rectangle, we're just simply going to do base multiplied by height. So that would be the base is 3 multiplied by the height, which is 12, which would give us 36. So that's the area of just the rectangle. So then for the entire area of this compound shape, all we have to do is add these together. So if we do 8, add our 36, we simply get 44. Then for our final answer, remember we've got to use the correct units. So we'd have 44 centimeters squared. And that would be our final answer. Okay, for this next question, we've actually got to find the area of the shaded region. So what we can do when we've got a question like this is to find the area of the entire shape and then just take away the bit that we don't need. So if we look initially, we've got this really big rectangle, which is 5 meters long by 3 meters tall. And that is all shaded. And then we're going to take away this little rectangle here, which if we look at the dimensions again, has a width of 1 meter and has a height of 2 meters. So for this first rectangle, we're just going to use the formula again for our rectangle of base times height. So that would simply just be 5 multiplied by 3, which is 15. So that would be the area of the entire rectangle. And then for the area of this smaller rectangle, again, area of rectangle is base times height. So we do 1 multiplied by 2, which is 2. So that's the area of the smaller one. And then because that bit's missing, we actually have to take that away. So we've got to do 15, take away 2, which gives us 13. So again, remembering to use the correct units, our final answer to this question would be 13, and then we'd be using meters squared. And that would be our final answer. And for this final one, we've got a bit of a problem-solving question. So we've got a homeowner is laying tiles on their patio as shown in the diagram. The tiles cost £30 per square metre. How much will it cost the homeowner to tile the entire patio? So for this question, all we have to do is find the area of the entire patio. And then once we've done that, we can find out what the total cost is going to be. So again, just like the previous questions, I'm going to split this compound shape into separate shapes. So for this particular one, all I'm going to do is cut along straight here. So the two shapes it's given me now, which I'm going to draw separately, is actually a square, because we can see there that we've got dimensions of 1 meter by 1 meter. So we'd have 1 meter here by 1 meter here. And then we've also got this rectangle. So looking for the dimensions of that, we can see we've got 4 meters for the base. Right, now we want to find what the height is. Well, if we go back to our square, if the length of this side here is 1 meter, we know all the sides of a square are equal, so this side just down to here would also be 1 meter. If the whole length of the left-hand side of that shape is 2 meters, that must mean this remaining bit down here must also be 1 meter. So I can put that on this new diagram here. So now to find the areas of the square and the rectangle, we're just going to do base times height. So for the square, if we do 1 meter times 1 meter, I'm going to write that in the middle, we get 1 meter squared. And then for our rectangle, we've got 4 meters multiplied by 1 meter, which would give us 4 meters squared. So just like the other questions, all I need to do now to find the total area is just add these two together. So I'd have 1 meter squared, add 4 meters squared. So that means the total area is just going to be 5 meters squared. So now we need to apply this to the question. We know that the tiles cost £30 per square meter. So if the patio is 5 meters squared, we're going to have to do £30 multiplied by that 5 meters squared. So we'd simply do 30 multiplied by 5, which gives us 150. So that's going to be the cost in pounds. So the cost to cover this whole patio would cost £150. And that's the final answer to this question. So well done if you followed along with those. And that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics at all that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments. And I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.